To understand how TypeScript resolves the location of the module we import, we need to understand the difference between the relative imports and non-relative imports. These are a few examples of the relative imports. The relative imports direct the compiler to a specified location on the file system where it can find the module. The relative references begins with either a slash or a dot slash or a dot dot slash to direct the compiler to the location of the file. Here, the reference to the software module is preceded by a slash that tells the compiler that the file may be found on the root of the file system. You can leave off the file extension and the compiler will automatically look for files with valid TypeScript extensions. The compiler will look for the person module in the same directory as the current file. For this, it will go one directory up and then it will look for order modules inside the picture directory. Here are a few examples of non-relative imports. These are almost same, but they don't include any references to a directory structure before the module name. These two lines import the Lodash and the jQuery modules, but they do not include any reference to the paths. We use non-relative references when referring to third-party modules, whereas we use relative references when referring to our own modules. Let us now see how TypeScript finds the files referred to with non-relative references. Module resolution strategies. TypeScript resolves the location of the module by first checking if they are relative or non-relative references. After that, it attempts to locate the module using the configured module resolution strategy. We can set the module resolution strategy using the module resolution compiler option. The two possible values you can pass to it are classic and node. The TypeScript documentation mentions that classic mode is available primarily for backward compatibility. However, it's important to have a general understanding of the differences between the two. The first thing to know is that the default value for the module resolution compiler option is dependent on what type of modules we have configured the compiler to emit. Classic mode is default resolution strategy if we are emitting AMD, UMD, system or ECMA 2015 module. For common JS module, node is the default resolution strategy. The process of resolving module in classic mode is very simple. We will check it now in a couple of minutes. If the mode is node, it's the same way node attempts to resolve the modules. Though it is not complex, it is certainly different from what happens here in the classic mode. Classic mode is less configurable, whereas we can configure the node strategy using the package.json file if it is present. Let us now have a look at some examples of how each of these modules would attempt to resolve both relative and non-relative references. Resolving relative imports in classic mode is pretty straightforward. Let us suppose this is a file named player.ts located in the source quickmat directory. Here, I have imported the person module and used dot slash to indicate that it is in the current directory. In this case, TypeScript will look for the person module in the person.ts file in the same directory. If the file is not found, it will look for the person.d.ts file in the same directory. It is a different standard TypeScript file extension which we can use with the type declaration file. These type declaration files provide type information for JavaScript libraries that we want to use in our TypeScript projects. We will talk more about it in the next chapter. So this way, TypeScript resolves relative imports in classic mode. The compiler looks for a file with one of these two extensions in the specified directory. Coming to the non-relative imports in the classic mode, this is a little more advanced. I have imported the same person module, but here I have not given any path reference and hence it is non-relative. The compiler will begin its search for the person module with the same two files, the files named after the module name, with either a ts or a d.ts extension. This time, if it doesn't find the file, it will go one level up in the directory structure and search for the same two files. It will continue moving up the directory structure until it either finds one of the files or run out of the directories. Now let us look at using the node resolution strategy with relative references. I'm using the same example import statement. TypeScript will first look for the person module in the current directory with one of the three valid TypeScript file extension. The TSX files are the TypeScript equivalent of the JavaScript JSX files used with popular frameworks like React. If those files don't exist, then the compiler will check for a file named package.json in a directory named after the module. If that file exists and has a types property in it, that directs the compiler to the correct file. Then that file will be used. Otherwise, the compiler will look in a directory named after the module. In that directory, it will search for a file named index with one of the same three valid TypeScript file extensions. The last one here is the node strategy with non-relative imports. I'll again use the same sample import, but this time with a non-relative reference to the person module. The first place the compiler will search for this module is in a subdirectory of the current directory named node modules. In the node modules directory, it will look for the file with the module name and the three TypeScript file extensions that we have discussed. If not found, it will then look for a package.json file in a directory named after the module inside node modules. It will then look in a subdirectory of node modules named types for a file named after the module with a d.ts extension. Then in a subdirectory of node modules named after the module for a file named index with one of the valid TypeScript extensions. If the compiler still hasn't found the module at this point, it will follow the same process up one level in the directory structure. The same searches will be performed here as well, and then it will continue moving up the directory tree, doing the same thing until it finds the modules or runs out of the directories. Looks like a lot of work, but don't worry. You now at least have an idea of how TypeScript attempts to resolve the modules. This makes it easier to figure out what's wrong when there is an inevitable error which says it can't find something that you're looking for to import. We also have a compiler option which we can use to output all the locations the compiler is searching. This is very helpful in troubleshooting module not found errors. Let us check out this in action in our demo and get our demo up and working with modules.